السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Before I start, let me ask you one question. What is terrorism? Terrorism is the act of instilling fear. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. The word terrorism derives from the word terror, meaning extreme fear. So, if we follow this context, it'd mean terrorism would mean instilling extreme fear, extreme horror. Let's think about that. Now, throughout history, there have been many terror attacks. There have also been many groups. I'm sure about that. But for some reason, Islam is seen as the main culprit for terrorism. Also, if you look at the meaning of the word terrorism, which means to instill fear, right? So now, if we follow the term, then I am pretty sure that every single person on earth has committed at least once, one act of terrorism. Why? I am pretty sure someone has terrorized someone, or something. They have instilled a bit of fear. For example, they must have forced someone. Or force someone to do a certain action, or blackmail someone, or why not even beat up a cat, or show a stick to a cat and make it scared. That is instilling fear. You are terrorizing the cat. You are terrorizing that person. Now, why are Muslims seen as the real perpetrators? Why? I don't see the main reason. Allah in the Quran says, if you kill one person, it's like you have killed entire humanity. And if you save one person, it's like you have saved entire humanity. Right? Now, Muslims should be following this ayah. Now you've got groups like ISIS, Al-Qaeda, and all these messed up, weird groups going on in Syria, in these places. Yeah? I don't believe, and I am 100% sure that these do not represent Islam. Islam is something peace. Islam derives from the word salam, which means peace. So how can killing be peaceful? Clearly it's not. It doesn't make sense. So these people, they're not Muslim. Also, in fifth verse, Allah says, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ, and do not kill you among each other. Do not kill a soul. So what does that say? What does that mean? You don't kill people. You don't kill anyone. You don't harm anyone. Inshallah, may Allah allow us to take some barakah from this, and Ameen. Terrorism. As I said previously, the term terrorism means to instill fear, right? Now, I am not 100%, not 200, I am billion percent sure. Why not? Trillion% sure that the government is doing these horrible acts. Let's take, for example, Burma and Syria. In Burma, Myanmar. Yeah, take that. The people there, they are being kicked out of their own land. Just cause what? They're Muslims? They are being terrorized by the government. The guards are shooting people, killing people, they're instilling extreme fear. And on top of that, people in Bangladesh, the closer country there, is not allowing anyone in. Take for example Syria. One of the most highest Islamic countries in the world. Now what happened? Reached dust. Why? America must have attacked it, destroyed it. Everyone has done terrorism. Even government, they may try to hide, but they are not. They may try. Let me tell you one thing. Why even go to Islamic countries? Let's go to Japan. Even World War II, when America dropped the bomb called Fat Man on Nagasaki. Is it yeah? Nagasaki. How do you think the people in Nagasaki felt? Well, I'm pretty sure they felt terrified. So what? Would you call that terrorism? Wouldn't you call people invading a country, wouldn't you call that terrorism? Oh, surely I would. I would. But the people there have been feeling terrified. Fair enough. Or in the media, what is most represented is the bombing. That's it. That's terrorism. It's not. Terrorism is when you instill fear for your own gains. Instill extreme fear for your own gains, for your personal gains, not for the gains of everyone. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.